joy that somehow there's a greater plan that operates this universe. And we're not here to figure it out, but we're here to love the mystery and to do the best we can with loving each other. So I thank you for your presence in this room. And does anyone have anything they'd like to share, say, sing, dance?
I'm going to say thank you
please.
For coming. Thank
please.
You. It's so great
to have
you.
We're
going to
do something
in
temple
feast.
Yeah, Saturday we're going to have Abdullah at temple feast. And that would be
and bring out the Torah.
We have a Torah. We'll dance with the Torah on Saturday. Yeah. It would be lovely.
So it's a potluck after this service and party. And spread that word.
We have wine, juice, we'll make a kiddush. And Brother Sky, it's always a love to see you. And thank you for drumming and holding the beat. And yes, man, we will do more of this.
And people who are coming tomorrow, if you have iPhones, if you can bring your iPhones, and we're collecting footage on tomorrow, whatever we can. If you have iPhones,
wow. Someone brought from tomorrow. LA.
And there's also chai.
This is a lovely container. You can hear the beaches. The beaches are teachers. The dance and music will be our songs. But there won't be very much preaching either on the beach.
The beach preaches to us.
And the music is the shaman. So we'll allow that to be. For Yom Kippur, there is a different venue, and we'll have it here. There'll be a little more silence and sitting and talking and awareness where we might have missed the mark and where we can improve our lives. Between now and Yom Kippur is called Aseret Yemei Teshuvah, the 10 days of turning. It's a time to call, write, talk, and then let those people who you have some unfinished business with, their unforgiving hearts, let it go. Let God, life's too short for this stuff. I think it was Anne Lamont who said, forgiveness is giving up all hope of having a better past. That's probably very true. So whatever happened, happened, and that's the way it is. Now you got to find your own peace in the present. It's more about you than the other. Because you can hold on to some hatred to another, but once again, Anne Lamont says, being unforgiving is like drinking rat poison and waiting for the rat to die. It doesn't work. So you got to find your own way to claim your own sense of peace in this world. Because everybody on some level is operating with as much love as they can muster in the moment. And there's a lot of short fuses. And there's a lot of contraction. Because we're all living with the illusion of separation. And our society encourages our separation. And we're alone. A big disease of our planet, especially our culture. I've been to tribal cultures in Thailand and Fiji, where they don't have anything really except each other and food, and you know that's enough. And that's really something. So what is it that we really need here? Love, each other, joy, celebration, affection, some food, shelter, a Maui minimal shelter, and make it, you know? Weather is kind, very kind. But we get into this thing where we're taught that we have to start a fire shed and we build these very, very large houses to hold a lot of stuff. And that's just the way this culture is. And it's not working. So most people have a bankruptcy of their neshama. It's harsh because they're alone. So we end up spending a lot of time eating and looking for affection and connection and wanting to feed ourselves. And instead of love, we have food and stuff and buying. This culture has a lot of challenges. A lot of challenges. Yom Kippur is more of a time to discuss it, to share with it, and to come together and reason, and maybe this is how we can do something different. Rosh Hashanah is a time for praise of creation. Dear God, you made an incredible world. Thank you for my part in it. How can I be a better person and how can I be of service? Let me know. And in 10 days, we have a fix-it. thank all the people who has made this event possible. Of course, first, the acknowledgement of our Creator, which we've been acknowledging all evening. I want to thank Mary and Gary for their blessings and bounty for helping us have this space and enjoy. And sweet Bonnie, for your voice and song and your spirit. My beautiful daughter, Zoe, for your presence in my life since you were a baby. A very, very wonderful journey. And a newfound brother who I met, and I don't know if I'll be able to leave him. My brother, Pat, Ostreicher, a very lovely, gifted Rebbe from Nueva York. Came here to celebrate the high holidays with us. So, oh yeah, Blue Mountain. And so, Rosh Hashanah is tomorrow. We're going to meet on the beach. You want to say where? I don't know exactly where.
Yes, we're going to meet at Kalawea Beach, White Rock Beach. And it's at the end of the Fairmont Kealani on the Old McKenna Road. I'll have signs out. You need to bring your beach gear, your sunscreen, your umbrellas, your...
moments to express to your Creator the intentions of your heart. This high holidays and every high holidays is called a time for teshuvah, a time for returning or turning into our true spiritual home, which is God. How could we ever leave? We can't. But for the awareness that we are there in our spirit, and for the blessings that our spirit home brings us. And to endeavor this year to be more kind, more caring, more loving, thoughtful, more peaceful, more playful. This is a time for rejuvenation. So, acknowledge the source from which we all come from. Acknowledge the source from where we are going to, and be grateful in the here and now for at least 18 blessings in our lives. Amen. Let's take 5 minutes. Quietness, listening. You don't have to be totally silent. If you're ever in an Orthodox synagogue, you know it. And there's a drone going on. Format within the services that I find very beautiful. And they're very body-centered. You know, it's very about movement. And the closing service is the Amida. And the Amida is a standing prayer. It's a standing prayer. And you stand in one place, but there is movement. There's movement when you, before you start the prayer, there's an acknowledgement of creation, so you take 3 steps forward. And then there's an awareness of awe and reverence, and you go 3 steps back. And you say, O Lord, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. And you bow and bend the knee, and you give thanks to our Creator for life. And the Amida traditionally has 18 blessings. So I invite you each in your own frame of reference, in your mind, in your heart, think of 18 blessings. That would be easy, you know. I mean, the beauty around you, family and friends, I don't have to give you ideas. Favorite foods, people, talents, skills, the senses. If you went with eyes, nose, and mouth, and touch, and toes that work, and fingers that are able to grasp, and touch, and feel. You just 18 in the first minute. So if you want to go over, it's okay. It's very easy to see. 18. then there's a part in the Amida where we acknowledge that we are holy beings, and we ask to be raised in holiness. So it's Hadol.
Every day of my life, and I
Prepare ourselves to acknowledge the oneness, the unity of creation.
So I would imagine that many of you here are not that adept in the language of Hebrew, but you're good English speakers, you're good smilers, singers, but the space of gratitude, how do we get to that place? So I invite you to close your eyes. I invite you to look on the inward eye, the blessings that our mutual Creator has bestowed upon us. The obvious ones of the beauty that we get to wake up to every day, the mountains, the valleys, the streams, the ocean, the flora, the fauna. The blessings of your own comfort, the roof over your heads, the furniture, the food, how it all got here, how it all got to use for our own personal enjoyment. If the only prayer we ever said was thank you, that would be sufficient. So essentially, Rosh Hashanah is a whole day of saying thank you in many, many different ways. To thank God, to give thanks for the blessings of our friendships, our family, our connections, our affection. It's amazing that there's anything here at all. And look at the infinite vastness of wonder and stuff that we get to have awe over. A number of months back, I was reading from one of my favorite poets, Mary Oliver. You know the poetry of Mary Oliver? When I found this one delightful enough to set memory into music. And she writes, she says, my work is loving the world. Here the sunflower, there the hummingbird, equal seekers of sweetness. Here the blue plum, there the quickening yeast. Here the clam, deep in the speckled sand. Are my boots old? Is my coat torn? Am I no longer young and nearly half perfect? Let me keep my mind on what matters, which is my work, which is mostly standing still and learning to be astonished. The Phoebe, the delphinium, the sheep in the pasture, and the pasture which is mostly rejoicing, because all the ingredients are here, which is gratitude. To be given a mind and a heart and these body clothes, a voice with which to give shouts of joy to the moth and the wren and the sleepy dugout clam, telling them all over and over how it is that we live forever. My work is loving this world. Indeed, that's our job here. And it's such a holy task. Love is the holiest of tasks. To care for each other, to be in service, to nurture, to enlighten, to entertain, to enthrall, to care for one another. That's the holiest job here. Our work is to love each other. The essence of Judaism, v'ahavta l'reach kamoch, to love your neighbor as yourself. Wow. Who is in my temple? Who is in my temple? All the doors have opened themselves. All the lights do light themselves. Darkness like a nightbird flies away, flies away. Darkness like a nightbird flies away. La 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 la. La 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 la. Develop those feelings or things that have meaning, and you will find loving. Perish the thought that values are bought, and money is all that is wealth. Dismiss the suspicion that life has no mission, and that no one really cares. If you feel for others as sisters, regard the conception that the need for affection is a weakness of body and mind. The essence of living is wrapped up in giving and leaving our fears behind.
Thank you. welcome toast again, please? Call to prayer in our tradition is called the Lord. Our sages tell us we should make at least 100 blessings a day. 100. It's a nice number. One followed by a couple of days. And the word for blessing is baruch. And it comes from the root of barakim, which is knees. What allows us to bend our knees? How are we in awe and in reverence? You know, the high holidays are the one time of the year when a traditional Jew gets to go. Prostrate ourselves before our Creator, who allows us to go down and do this. Where is one? So the call to prayer, Barahu, Baruch, blessed, Ata, thou, Yah, Yah. The sound syllable Yah exists in every major religion. Yah and Ba are two main sound syllables for creation. If you've ever done any chanting and mantras, you know the power of those sounds. Magic of breath. Where does it come from? Where does it go? Each one of them is different. So when we say Baruch Hu, we bend our knees. Baruch Hu. Et Yah. Hanavorach, who is blessed. Blessed is Yah, who is and the response is Baruch Yah HaMevorach Le'olam Vo'ed. Blessed is Yah who is blessed forever. I love forever. When you start looking through the lens of eternity, things somehow have a very good the ego only sees sort of the past, the future. The spirit rests in the present and is eternal. So it has a very different view. So let us see with the eyes of compassion, love, kindness, mercy, within the framework of the eternal. We're over here in this body. Very short time. You think about it forever. So it's a learning vehicle for holding our spirit, for helping us integrate this sensational world that we're in. The sensations are not always pleasant, but they are nevertheless sensational. So, find our peace. Find our prayer, find our praise in this moment, Ashad. Oh, how about C for creation? C major.
Ah.
Next prayer in the traditional liturgy, Abbas Olam, for the love of this world. We acknowledge our Creator. We ask for peace in the world and a canopy of peace to be spread over this world.
Thank you.
blessings of our connections, affection, awareness of gratitude, appreciation, thanksgiving for this awesome journey of life that we are living. Our joys, our challenges, the incredible blessings of light, contractions of the dark and the shadows, the infinite array of potential possibilities. How does one greet a new year? It's beautiful that the new year is welcomed by the sounding of the horn. It's not about words, it's about listening. Tone, sound, beat the drum, the timbre, dance, sing, clap your hands in joy and gladness, and put on some happy feet and dance together. Welcome to the beauty of this sacred temple, the roundness, continuity of creation, the circles. We are here to acknowledge a new year. Judaism has four new years. This is one of them. Rosh Hashanah, Rosh is head, Hashanah, the year, the head of the year. It's not the first month in the Jewish calendar, but it's a time of the change of seasons. And awareness of the continuity of creation, and finding our place, and claiming our peace, and being grateful. So for this evening, my dear fellow rabbis, rabbi means teacher, and I'm grateful that in our tradition there's no hierarchy of teachers. We're all ministers and teachers of the spirit of holiness to each other. I'm not going to do much preaching. In other words, not much talking. This might be all the talking I might do is a little invocation and but doubt. Though I enjoy the word, it has its place. But we're never going to figure out our life with words. That's why the space of quietness, the space of touch, the space of tone, of art, of dance, encounter, silence, will reveal to us more of our true nature as creative, mystic beings who are here to celebrate a glorious creation in joy, wonder, and love. So I thank you for your presence here to warm the space, to warm each other's hearts, to smile on each other and bless each other in holy love. So the customary greeting is L'shana Tova, assume a good new year, or a good Yontif in Yiddish, a good Yom Tov, Happy New Year. And so before we go into the first song, let's use our eyes to bless each other, and we're just going to walk around slowly. Maybe my beautiful dear brother Matt will play something quiet and simple. Maybe like Kini Makova Manayim. Maybe like in the key of maybe D minor for the divine or A minor for all. One of those, or G minor for God, whatever you want. Kini Makova Manayim. Oh, how good and how pleasant it is for us to dwell together in unity. So look in each other's eyes, remember the connections that each of us have to each other. Smile and be glad. Happy New Year. I.
sorry, you can't hear me. I could use the mic, but let me try to speak up. Okay? And I'll stand on my feet. I don't even limit my speaking more. So, all Jewish holidays begin at sundown, and they go for a period of time, and they conclude at sundown, and they begin with the lighting of the candles. And we have one candle here, and it was Bonnie Newman's mother's Al Shalom candle. It's something she rescued from the house when the house burned out. So there's a beautiful sentiment of the tradition that gets carried from generation to generation. So I'd like to invite Bonnie to light the lights, and I'd like to, for us, three's a charm, right? Okay, so address the light here, the one candle, and we're going to look at the light, and we find out.
Did not our mutual creator make me a love of God? It's a holy day.
It's a holy day.
It's a
it's a holy day. way back there? Or?
Better?
Yeah, it's good.